Roflumilast is a non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug indicated for the maintenance treatment of patients with severe chronic obstructive pulmonary disease with frequent exacerbations. Due to the fact that patients over the age of 40 years significantly predominate in the general population of this disease when prescribing the drug to patients under 40 years of age, spirometric confirmation of the diagnosis of chronic obstructive pulmonary disease is required. Indications. As maintenance therapy in the treatment of severe chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, post-bronchodilation forced expiratory volume in the first second should be less than 50% of the calculated due value in adult patients with a history of frequent exacerbations. How to use? The drug is administered orally at a dose of 500 micrograms one time per day. To achieve a therapeutic effect, treatment may be required for several weeks. Contraindications. Moderate or severe liver failure. Age up to 18 years. Efficacy and safety not established. Pregnancy. Lactation period. Breastfeeding. Hypersensitivity to the components of the drug. Serious immunodeficiency diseases. Serious acute infectious diseases, such as tuberculosis or acute hepatitis. Chronic heart failure, functional class 3 and 4. Treatment with immunosuppressive drugs. Rare hereditary diseases such as galactose intolerance, lactose deficiency or glucose-galactose malabsorption. Depression associated with the appearance of suicidal thinking and behavior. Special instructions. The drug is not intended for the treatment of an acute attack of shortness of breath, acute bronchospasm. The patient should be warned that in order to relieve an acute attack, it is important to always have a drug prescribed by a doctor to stop an attack. The drug in this case is not effective. The use of roflumilast is associated with an increased risk of psychiatric disorders such as insomnia, anxiety, nervousness, and depression. In the course of clinical studies, rare cases of manifestations of suicidal thinking and behavior have been identified. Despite the fact that adverse reactions such as diarrhea, nausea, abdominal pain and headache occur mainly in the first weeks of treatment and in most cases disappear with continued treatment, if the symptoms persist, treatment with the drug shall be reconsidered. Side effects from the digestive system: often diarrhea, nausea, abdominal pain. Infrequently, gastritis, vomiting, gastroesophageal reflux disease, dyspepsia. Rarely, hematochezia, constipation. On the part of the psyche, often insomnia, infrequently anxiety, rarely nervousness, depression. In clinical trials, there have been reports of rare cases of suicidal thinking and behavior, including completed suicide. Patients should be instructed to report all manifestations of suicidal ideation to their physician. Signs are cardiovascular system, infrequently, tachycardia. From the respiratory system, rarely, respiratory tract infections, except pneumonia. From the nervous system, often, headache, infrequently, tremor, vertigo, dizziness, rarely, dysgeusia. From the endocrine system, rarely, gynecomastia. From the site of metabolism and nutrition, often, weight loss, loss of appetite. Dermatological reactions, infrequently, rash. Allergic reactions, infrequently, hypersensitivity, rarely, urticaria, angioedema. From the musculoskeletal system, infrequently, muscle spasms and muscle weakness, myalgia, back pain, rarely, an increase in creatine phosphokinase in the blood. Other, infrequently, malaise, asthenia, fatigue.